Today we're going to look at how to create accessible math content using MathType. MathType is actually a program that comes into your Microsoft Word window as part of your ribbon. So what you first do is open up a Microsoft Word document, and then we're going to click on MathType. Notice when we click on MathType, we are going to get a new ribbon here. And what we want to do is we want to insert an equation. So I'm going to go up and click on inline, and inline is going to give us the ability to put an equation into our document. Once I do that, my math editing window comes up, and I'm able to type in whatever I want, and there's also all of the mathematical symbols that we would need to create anything from algebra up through calculus. So I'm going to start with something very simple. I'm just going to do a simple quadratic, and I don't need to use the space bar at all because MathType automatically formats everything for me. So I'm just going to keep typing. So I'll type 3x, and now I want to put a power on that expression, so I notice my blinking cursor here is around the 3x. Well, I'm going to come up here into my bar and select this button right here because you can see that that's going to give me the ability to put in an exponent. Once I do, my blinking cursor has left my 3x and now comes up into the position so that I can type in my squared. Now, in order to get back to finishing off my quadratic, I need to take that blinking cursor and get it back down. And the way to do that is to hit the tab key. Notice once I hit the tab key, now my blinking cursor has gone down underneath and it is enclosing that entire expression. That tells me that I'm done with that and I can move on. So I will type in plus 5x. Minus 7, and I have created my quadratic. Now if I had to go back and edit everything, I could tab back through, and notice when I hit the tab key, it gives me the ability to go in and make some changes. I'm just going to hit the enter key and go down and type a second expression. I'll make it a little more involved this time. Let's try something with a radical. If I go up into my toolbar and I choose that radical, it gives me my square root, and I'm going to type an actual expression as opposed to just a number there. So let's say 6x plus 9. Now my blinking cursor is still sitting underneath the radical, so if I kept typing it would just extend that radical. But I want to get out from under that, so again I'm going to hit the tab key. When I do that, notice now it has changed and it's showing me that I can move on, and I'll just put in a minus 10 and I'm done. So I'm just going to hit the enter key and I'm going to say, well, that's all I want to put in for today. So I will go up to File, Close and Return to Document 1. Notice I could have just updated it and kept going, but for today I'm going to close and Save Changes, yes. And once I do that, you can see my Word document now has those equations, well, this quadratic expression and this radical expression. I shouldn't have said equations because there's no equal sign there. Now we're going to go ahead and save our document. We have to save it in Word before we actually go to publish it. So I'm going to click File, Save As, and I want to save this as a .doc file. So I'm going to go up to 97-2003 document, .doc, and I will call this Today's Test and click Save. Now I can go and publish to Math Page. When I do that, my little window comes up. I could title my page, and I want to choose using MathML. When I go down and choose using MathML, notice it gives me all browsers, Windows, Macintosh, Linux, but I don't want that. I need Internet Explorer. So I'm going to click on this down arrow and choose Math Player, i.e. Behavior. Once I do that, notice that my target browser changes and I have exactly what I want, and I can click OK. It's processing the equations. And notice my window has changed and my Math Player logo has come up, so I should be able to read this now with JAWS. I am going to turn on my screen reader, and it may take a minute to load. We'll come up here and we'll hit insert
table
down
with three
again.
Rows and one column, row one, column one, 3x squared plus 5x minus 7, row two, column one, square root of 6x plus 9, and root minus 10, row three, column one, end table.
But what we've managed to do here now is we've managed to create screen reader accessible mathematics, which is something that is very important.